Hello and welcome to KGEM Live. That's right, KGEM Live, a show that will provide entertainment and information about events happening in and around Monrovia. I'm Ralph Walker, your host today, and longtime familiar face on KGEM. A fun fact about me is that my favorite TV show is PBS, documentaries, and libations that happens on KGEM. Speaking of which, what's happening in the new old town in Monrovia? In downtown Monrovia, we're seeing a lot of changes in food. Recently, a new store on Myrtle called Sweet Ethan's has come out. We're going to take a closer look in our segment, Monrovia Eats.
If you got a sweet tooth, then you gotta visit Sweet Ethan's, a family-run business right here in Monrovia. Sweet Ethan's is next on Monrovia Eats.
Monrovia Eats is brought to you by Hey SoCal and the following.
We own, together with our six children, Sweet Ethan's.
Names are Colin, the oldest, 21. We have Lauren at 17. We have Julia at 14. We have Sarah at 13. And we have Valerie at 11. And little Ethan, Sweet Ethan, which the name is store is named after, he is going to be 5 in about a month.
He remembered all of them. Good.
Sweet Ethan started, well, let's go back to my background. My background is my family's retail grocers in the Bay Area for 50 years. Mm-hmm. So with that said, this is how it all kind of created.
Mm-hmm. And through COVID, we decided with the children, we kind of needed something that brought some joy to the community and to our family.
And they wanted to have the kids, you know, get out of the house, get off their phones, you know, start working and getting older, so then you start getting the habit of, you know, doing multitasking, school and work and so forth.
Yeah.
And so we manage buildings in this area, and we were looking for a spot, and this one came up, and I said, what do you want to do here, Kelly? And so I don't know, I said, well, you know, let's do a candy store, because every time we go on vacation, you spend a lot of money on candy. So it's got to be good.
Uh-huh.
I never once thought about being a candy business, not once. After the groceries were done, we did delis and stuff like that. So I was looking for food service. But so this came up, and it's been a great hit. It's been a smash hit since we opened.
It's been a lot of fun, and the children are really involved and doing every part of it as well. So it's been a real family effort.
Especially we have specialty products, which is our caramel apples, which are fantastic, and our cupcakes and our cookies. But we also, everything we bring in, like the macaroons are from Macaroon Queen in Atlanta, and they're pretty famous. They were on the Profit Show, and that's kind of why I brought them in. But they literally, I'm not a macaroon expert, but they melt in your mouth.
They're delicious.
So everything from the fudge is made for us, and the bombs are made for us.
Mm-hmm.
Whatever I bring in, even products on the shelf, it's got to be premium.
But we have, you know, from CBD to CBD in, you know, infused chocolates, candies, to alcohol infused candies, to just fun, humorous chocolates and mints and things like that. And so it really is very fun, just to, you know, they allow for fun gifts and a lot of discussion. Thank you for coming into our store.
Thank you very much.
It's a pleasure to be in the community. It is a pleasure to see the smiles of everyone that comes in here. And we're just so blessed and grateful for everyone and each of you. Thank you.
I think it's all in the name. Sweet Ethan's is the place to go if you want to satisfy that sweet tooth. And I remember as a kid loving Mars bars, Paydays, and occasional turtle candy. That was a rare treat. I ate so much candy one year, I had to go to the dentist and they had to extract a tooth from me. So one year, I didn't eat candy. That didn't last long. All right, today our main story is talking about Monrovia Rocks, not a band. What do you know about Monrovia Rocks? Hand-painted rocks that are hidden around Monrovia. Let's take a look.
Hello, everyone.
Oh, my God. It's Monrovia's famous artist, Joey Gonzalez.
Hey there.
How you doing?
Then who are you talking to?
Well, I'm talking to everyone out there in TV land.
Well, that's wonderful to know.
Yeah. Can't you see him right there?
Yes, I can see them all sitting right there relaxing. Hi there.
So, what are you doing?
Well, normally I would be out painting and focusing on making artwork, but lately my attention is being drawn to Monrovia's local rocks being painted.
Oh, I've seen those around. What's that all about?
Well, local community, since we're all a little bit stressed at the moment, are out there at home whenever they have a chance. Local Monrovians are taking the opportunity to take river rocks and paint them and display them all over town. It's a treasure trove of artwork all around the city that you, as anyone, any ages, can look for them. Some are for taking, some are not for taking. So please check the rocks to see if they're welcome to be taken. There are many of these rocks right here at our city hall that everyone can check out as
yes.
well.
Now, is there like a director of this organization or?
There is no director. There is no central organization to this. This is purely a good intention. You're out there doing your artwork. You're painting these rocks and putting them out for people to find them and see them.
And what's the, and there's only one rule I heard.
It's all about kindness.
And no negativity.
No negativity.
Wow. Well, that's great. And then there's a forum, of course.
Yes, for anyone who'd like to get involved, there's the Monrovia Rocks page on Facebook. And they encourage you to take a picture of your rock that you find and display it there so that we know it found its forever home.
Wow. And some of them, I guess, you can keep, and then some you can just move to a different spot.
Yes, it really is a free-for-all.
I heard it says it's the most diversified group there is.
It's all walks, persuasions, flavors, and genres.
Ages.
There's no set limit to how creative a person can be with the rocks. It's welcome for all ages. Kids are welcome to paint the rocks. We just encourage that if you're going to be out there painting these rocks, please seal your rocks so that the artwork will stay longer.
Yes. And of course, wash your hands before and after touching every rock.
Yes.
To keep safe.
To be safe out there.
Well, thank you, Joey. Elbow bump. And
thank you very much.
And we'll talk to you soon. Bye.
Thank you, Joey Gonzalez and Dirk. Now, isn't that fun? This organization has started in Monrovia around January 20th in 2018, and since then, many individuals have been making and hiding these rocks everywhere. So if you have nothing to do for a day, take a friend and go find the coolest rock you can find. Go on a rock hunt.
Hey, Ralph, do you think you could paint a nice rock?
Well, I'm not much of an artist, but Charles at George Fisher in Orindale did this. He took a rock, which was a blank canvas, and he made a mic. I can't drop it because it's pretty heavy. Always a cool thing because I always remember that, oh, what's that thought? life is a canvas, and what you put on it can stay. All right, I do have a brief rock story. One time I was in St. Thomas, Jamaica, and I was walking along the beach. And on this beach, all the rocks are round. And so I picked up one as a tourist, a souvenir, put it in my luggage, got to make it through customs. And the man says, the alarm goes off. They asked me to step out of line. They asked the question, what's in your luggage? Jamaica, you know what everyone is thinking. So he pulls out a rock and he says, and what are you doing with this? And I said, well, I couldn't take Jamaica with me, so I thought I'd take a piece of Jamaica, a rock. So that's a rock story. Oh, don't forget, coming up this weekend, it's a birthday celebration as Monrovia celebrates 135 years old. Monrovia Days on the 14th, the 15th, and the 16th. It seemed like it was only yesterday that I was hosting a parade with Jennifer Ranger in 1999. Uh-oh, they tell me today, hot off the press, it's the last day to submit a rock to be featured in a permanent art display in Library Park. Monrovia Rocks will be joining the cultural image of our city, whether it be a poem on the sidewalk or painted utility boxes. The spirit of humanity has always been found in the arts. The opening ceremony starts at 10:15 a.m. on Saturday. And speaking of art, we have all types of artists here in Monrovia. Today, we have, well, James is in the studio. He's going to be talking about his podcast, which is celebrating a 2-year anniversary this month. Let's go to James.
Good evening, everyone. My name is James DeLicio. I'm a current senior at Monrovia High School, and I'm also one of the hosts of the Socratic Cinema podcast. Socratic Cinema is a podcast about all things film. Every episode, I'm joined by my two best friends, Charlie Heatherly and Casey Clark. Each week, we talk about a new movie to try and figure out what works and what doesn't. There's always a lot of laughs, angry rants, and plenty of unpopular opinions. As Ralph said, we're getting ready to celebrate our 2-year anniversary at the end of this month. To celebrate, we're going to be putting on a Socratic Awards show, where we're going to be looking back over the past year at all of our favorite memories. And fans have actually voted on their favorites, so we'll be giving out awards. Right now, I'd like to play a clip for you from one of our most recent episodes, but before I do that, I just wanted to let you know that if anything I've said sounds fun to you, you can always find Socratic Cinema on YouTube, Spotify, Apple Podcasts, or anywhere where you find fine podcasts. In this clip, Charlie, Casey, and I are competing to come up with the best pilot combination to fight the huge fighting robots found in one movie we recently talked about, Pacific Rim. Let's go ahead and enjoy the clip. Thank you for your time.
My pick is Crimson Typhoon, piloted by the Hemsworth brothers. I want all three of the Hemsworth brothers inside of Crimson Typhoon working together with their Australian magic. Because as we saw, the Australians are the best at fighting.
Ooh, I think I have half of a pilot pair. So I would pick Gypsy. And I know for sure that one of the pilots has to be Jason Momoa.
I'm going to go with Striker Eureka because I like how fast it is and I like the chest rockets. And as far as pilots, what about John Travolta and Nick Cage from Face Off? And if I can't get them, I want Frog and Toad from the children's book series Frog and Toad.
Oh, I have my second pilot.
Who's your second pilot? Oh, this can wait.
The Rock.
Oh, I think Casey wins.
Yeah,
Gypsy
baby.
Danger with The Rock and Jason. Jesus
Jason
Christ.
Momoa.
Wait, I raise you C-3PO and R2-D2.
I raise you the Jonas Brothers in Crimson Typhoon.
How about Honeydew and Beaker from The Muppets?
Oh.
Oh, yeah.
God, wait. What if we get the Russian Jaeger. And inside of that, we put Conor McGregor and Mike Tyson.
Gypsy Danger, piloted by Jesse and James from the Pokemon anime.
Yes.
It's a powerful choice for
wow.
me.
Oh, I have one final Crimson Typhoon that I'll raise you. I'll raise you Lakeith Stanfield, John Boyega, and Daniel Kaluuya.
Oh,
and
yes.
And it's just like the Black Power Jaeger.
I love it.
All right. Thank you again, James. Sounding like a true Monrovia High School valedictorian. Almost couldn't get it out. Happy anniversary. And thank you so much for that piece. And now we go to man and woman's best friend. And if you have no friends, you know you can always get a dog. If there's one thing I know about Monrovians is that they love dogs. They live with us, they eat with us. They can save people from burning buildings. A recent question has come up that some people look like their dogs. Do you? We decided to send a correspondent on the streets to ask people what they think.
Ladies and gentlemen, we are here in beautiful Monrovia, California, asking people if they think their dogs look like them. So the question that we all have on our minds is, studies show that people who own dogs look like their dogs. Do you think you look like your dog?
Not quite. I see other people that look like their dogs, okay. So I don't know if I look like her.
Do you think you look like your owner? I don't think he speaks English. Do you own a dog? Do you have a dog?
Yes.
What kind of dog do you have?
He's a mutt.
Would you say you look like your dog?
Maybe when I have a beard.
Understandable. Understandable. Thank you for your time. No dogs here. So we have to go in the producer's car and look for them. Come on, Monrovia. Do better. Excuse me, ladies. Do you mind if we ask a few questions about your dog here? So would you say you look like your dog?
Look at these eyes. These are hound dog eyes. Yes, totally hound dog eyes.
Not my dog.
Not your dog. Do you own a dog?
I do not. But if I did, it would look just like me. I'm here.
Okay. Any comments? Any comments for us? Do you guys think you look like your dog?
Oh, ha! Hilarious. I think people look like their dog, but I don't think that I'm.
You don't think? Why specifically not your dog?
Why specifically not mine?
Yes.
Okay, let me start. Yeah.
What do you guys think?
Yeah.
People at home.
I'm not thinking I look alike. We don't have the blonde hair. We don't have the shaggy beachy waves, right?
It's fair. It's a fair resemblance. This lady, on the other hand, this is like night and day. It's like,
right?
If there was an ID photo.
Sisters, right?
If there was an ID photo with her and the dog, like I couldn't tell the difference.
Right?
Honestly, I couldn't tell the difference.
Right.
It's the same. any comments?
Nice, right? It's very cool. People. Stop giving up your dogs. I just got into this with next door. You're doing a thing on dogs, people, they're not furniture. If you get one, it's for life, it's your family. If you ain't gonna give up your kid, you don't give up your pets.
Exactly, that's good.
I agree.
Okay? Little pee.
A lot of people say, I don't know if you've heard the sentiment that people who own dogs often look like their dogs.
Uh-huh.
So the question is, do you think you look like your dog?
Oh, yes, I do.
Like it? Perfect resemblance.
Yes.
Do you think your dog acknowledges the fact that they might look like you?
No, not at all.
You don't think they're cognitive enough for that?
No, no.
Understandable.
We're here on Myrtle Avenue looking for some dogs to talk to. Stay tuned. It's gonna get pretty rough out there, mate.
Do you think you guys look like your dogs?
You tell us.
What do you guys think at home? I give it a 6 out of 10 resemblance. Personality-wise, what do you guys think? You guys think you're similar to your dogs personality-wise? You sleep a lot, eat a lot?
Oh, she definitely resembles her mother.
Oh,
truth be told, I'm an 80-pound golden retriever. It's kind of stupid, but I love to do that. See, they might not look in the face like each other, but they definitely got the color scheme. The white on the white, the black on the black. I mean, match made in heaven right there.
Very fashionable too. Sure. All right.
Well, a lot of people say, you probably heard it, some people say that dogs look like their owners. Do you think you look like your dog at all?
No. He's my girlfriend's dog, but
Girlfriend's dog? You think your girlfriend looks like your dog?
No comment. I can't.
No comment? Do you have like a love-hate relationship where you fight over who loves her more?
No, we're good.
You guys are good.
We're best friends, actually.
All right, final question for you.
Yes.
Would you ever get matching shoes with your dog?
I would. I absolutely would. The drip would be insane.
Like Yeezys? Yeezys kind of move, or what do you think?
I would get some just like that.
Just like that?
Paw print and everything.
So there you have it, Monrovia. I've been Joe Ganley, and I guess people who own dogs do kind of look like their dogs.
They say it's time to wrap the show. Monrovia Live. From the city of Monrovia. Sending love from KGEM-TV.